What's up, everybody? Welcome back. Today is day 3.
Hey, Henry.
Oh nice. Yep. All right, I was just fixing the window.
What do you look like?
Why are you asking?
Because I'm horribly superficial.
I could be Tom Cruise's good-looking twin brother.
Oh, that's too bad. I read in People he's like 5 foot nothing.
Yeah, well, you can't win them all.
Okay, well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing shorts.
It's hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white. It's not very, PC or whatever they say.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man. I don't need a spotting scope for that. And if not shorts, then what do you normally like to wear?
Tuxedos as often as possible.
Oh, really?
You bet.
How cosmopolitan. I didn't realize Boulder was so chic.
It is the peak of high society. I
had to take my thing off.
Good to know, dear. Yes. Now tell me about your face. I'm looking at you across the bar. What do I see?
A pretty thick beard.
Oh, have you always had a beard?
For a while, yeah.
All right, perfect. I want to know about your eyes.
Get out of here.
I'm drawing you. I need to know.
Your what?
Is that okay? Don't answer. I'm going to do it regardless.
Nice.
Fine.
Your eyes, tell me.
They look tired, I think.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you know, you hit a certain age and you think you're a younger person who just looks tired all the time.
Speak for yourself, mister.
I guess that's getting old.
Well, some people might see distinguished. Okay, got it. Thank you, Henry.
You get what you need?
Absolutely.
Look for boards, I guess. Wash my head every time I come up. I have to do this every time, but
I got that window all patched up. So what should I do now? What's next?
What's next? What do you think is next?
Well, you've been the one giving me tasks for 2 days straight.
What's next is you sit in that room until September 1st and call me at the first sign of smoke.
Oh, huh. Yeah.
Why don't you let me know when you're mentally prepared for that task and I'll give it to you.
Okay, I think I am ready to tackle my long-term commitment of keeping this national forest safe from total destruction.
I am glad to hear you've really thought this through.
Of course.
We've issued you a comfy chair to sit in and everything.
You know, it's not really that comfy. It's wooden and there's no padding. I think I actually got a splinter in my thigh this morning.
Aww. Well, regardless, take a seat. The forest depends on you.
Nice. Alright, so now it's day 9. That's only 4 minutes, so we'll keep it running. Alright. Oh, nice. I'm down back by the canyon.
Hello, Henry. Having a nice afternoon?
I might never leave.
Well,
that's beautiful.
I called with some bad news. Two young young women, Chelsea Stevens and Lily McLean, were reported missing. They've got parents out in California who haven't heard from them in a week. They were supposed to meet an aunt down in Cody. If they're the girls from last week, then you're probably the last person to have seen them.
You should tell whoever that I'm happy to be questioned.
Look, it's not gonna be an issue. I mean, if they turn up dead, then maybe.
Check the
electrics
first.
Should I just not say anything and save us the trouble? I'm gonna take your silence as maybe we just don't say anything. All right, Henry, thanks. Enjoy the
works for me. Now it's day 15. All right, so we went from 3 to 9 to 15. I think it's like a 60-day job, 2 months. I'm not sure.
Henry.
Oh, shit.
Henry, wake up.
Get out of bed
and pick up the radio.
What do you want?
Hey, you big dumb idiot.
Hi, Jules.
Oh, you sound tired.
Small life.
I am.
I don't
Are you
this.
Having a nice time?
I got cold chills.
Yeah, it's good here. It's beautiful, you know?
What?
That's great, Henry. Really great. Well, I'll let you get back to sleep then.
Okay, Jules.
Delilah seems nice.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
Bye, baby.
Day 33. So we went from 3 to 9 to 15 to 33. So it might be more than 60 days.
Is it too much of a pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our towers?
Well, I get my stuff hand-delivered.
Oh, how's that work?
It's the perks of a decade of service. You're out hiking in 90-degree heat, and I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair?
I guess it's all summer.
Anyway, when you find the supply drop, remember, it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, I don't want to have to call in for more. There should be loads of good stuff, though. Beans, prunes, jerky. You know, my sister eats 6 prunes a day. 6. She's, like, really precise about it. She'd be great at this job if she didn't need wheelbarrows full of marijuana to function. So, like, 2 weeks ago, you called me in the middle of the night? You were sleeping, I guess, and all I heard was the name Jules through the mumbles. I just thought it was so sweet. I wanted to wake you up, but then I thought maybe you were having a nice conversation and I'd just be spoiling it. I hope you're doing okay, you know, when it comes to her.
I shouldn't be out here.
Yes, you should.
No, I just ran away from my problems.
No, you didn't. We all fuck up. Look, so a couple of months before I took this job, I was with this guy, Javier. Ugh, he's incredible, caring, sexy as hell.
Javier.
He was a driller down in Casper. We dated for almost 5 years. I was working with the Wyoming Outdoor Leadership School, and I was obsessed with it. I wanted to be an instructor so badly. I was sure I was going to marry Javier as soon as I could be bothered. Waltz was also a good excuse to get out of town, drink whiskey in the mountains, cut loose. Then, Javier's brother got killed working in Gillette, and for some reason, I didn't come home. Javier said it was fine. He'd go to the funeral, take care of his mom, stuff like that. It'd be easier solo. When he came back, he left me. I came out here, I lied and told my sister he fucked our neighbor. So, I lied to you. I came out here with a broken heart just like you. much about you, so, you know, there's something about me. We both fucked up.
That's fair.
All right, I got everything I need out of here. Time to chow down.
Just yours, right?
Who do you think I am?
Nice, already day 64. Oh, shit.
You've got a front row seat for what might be the biggest fire of the year.
Yeah, it's really going.
I'm gonna call it in. They'll send in a hotshot crew for some suppression, but I bet we'll be stuck with her for the rest of the summer.
Nice.
And she doesn't have a name yet. I usually think of something funny or something practical or a little risque when coming up with them. But why don't you do the honors?
Delilah's a nice name.
No, you big dummy.
I was kidding.
No, you were not. You're sweet, but we can't call it the Delilah Fire.
Okay, what then?
How about my middle name, June?
The June Fire, even though it's July.
I like it.
Nice, change the name.
So there's this creek down the hill, and, you know what my favorite thing to do is?
What's that?
I love to take a bottle of whatever I have on hand, plunge it deep into the water, and let it chill in there all day. And then, on nights like tonight, when it is so disgustingly hot, I have something nice and cool to drink. I learned that from my sister in Santa Fe. She'd do that with a bottle of tequila near her house and make margaritas the size of your head. You'd like it there.
I'm sure I would. Sounds pretty great.
It is. Are you looking at the fire?
Yeah, I am.
I love how they look at night. During the day, it's just smoke, but when the sun is down, you can just get lost.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're here.
Sure you are.
I am.
I don't know what that means.
Get it. And with Julie and everything, you probably don't want to be here.
I don't know if that's true.
Forget I said anything. I just meant I like that you're here. Why don't we both just go watch this fire and try to imagine all the old dead things it's burning away?
Day 76. How many days is in summer? No, it's going all the way to September. September 1st, and it's July.
You're going fishing without a license?
It's one fish, and I'm sick of all the stuff I got to eat.
Nice.
No, I won't tell anyone you're a poacher. That reminds me, I keep hearing reports from Fish and Game about a problem bear they're trying to keep tabs on. Can you search around the lake for fresh tracks and just let me know what you find? There was a crew burning fire lines out to the east, and, you know, I think sometimes it riles up the wildlife.
I like that fireworks are still there.
Sure, no problem. Remember me fondly.
You are such a drama queen.
Can't believe I'm gonna leave this planet as a pile of bear shit.
The corner.
Thank you, Henry.
Yeah. Someone left their clipboard out here.
Huh. It could have been one of the Fish and Game folks. See if there's a name or a credential or something. I can call it in.
What? It's... Holy shit.
What's going on? You didn't actually find a bear, did you?
Someone has written down what we said to each other, have been saying.
That doesn't make any sense.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you, not in the same way.
No way.
Wait, hold on. Something's out here.
Henry, I'm worried. You didn't find and eat any mushrooms, did you. I mean, they can be fun, but also, you know, devastating.
I found a walkie-talkie out here, too.
Okay.
It's going shithouse.
That scared the shit out of me, bro. Oh,
Henry,
hurt.
Are you there?
Oh.
What happened, Henry?
Got knocked over the fucking
head.
Punched
or something by someone.
Are you serious? What the hell is going on out there?
I don't know. Jesus Christ.
Let me get this straight. You found a clipboard with transcripts of our conversations? What else is on it?
I don't know. It's gone, along with a radio of theirs.
Are you fishing now?
Somebody out here could have just killed me, Delilah.
I don't... What the fuck is going on?
What's Wapiti Station?
I don't know.
I saw the name Wapiti Station right before I was cold cocked. Does Wapiti Station mean anything to you?
Wapiti Meadow. Maybe it's Wapiti Meadow. It's on our maps. It's not too far from where you are right now. It's north of the lake. It looks like there should be a trail somewhere on the north shore of Jonesy Lake.
I'll start hiking that way now. God damn it, my head.
Are you sure you saw what you saw, Henry? Maybe you pissed off some more campers and they came back to sucker punch you.
There are people listening to our conversations. The person or these people were hiding in the bushes down here. What the fuck, D?
I don't know, Henry. This sounds crazy.
Yeah, and you're not the one who just saw our words on a clipboard out in the middle of nowhere.
Those words were from 2 weeks ago.
I know they were. So what's to say that they don't have transcripts from 3, 4, or 5 weeks ago?
Our entire relationship, friendship, our whole summer.
Someone is out here with a walkie-talkie, taking notes and talking to God knows who. I'll hike out there and get some answers.
Great.
That's an old one.
Just keep a clear head. Don't, you know, do anything crazy.
Like taking a job in the middle of nowhere with literally no escape from whatever or whoever is out there?
Well, I meant, like, kill anybody.
You got it, boss.
That's weird. I've never noticed that. Alright, so when I first started playing this, I'm 90% sure that every time I went somewhere, I went the wrong way.
Whoa, Delilah, there's a big chain link fence between me and the meadow. I don't think I can get past it.
A fence?
Yeah.
How big?
Big. It goes off in both directions, acres. Looks like goddamn Area 51.
What?
Got aliens. That'd be exciting.
Yeah, we'll see about that. Look, I'm not gonna be able to get into this place.
Oh, shit.
I don't know how long I can dick around out here until someone notices.
God, if you were an actual firefighter, you'd have that gate down in 2 shakes. Actually, those guys doing the controlled burn, they might be able to help.
Where are they?
Beyond Ruby River, there's a scout camp. They burned a line a few days ago that should let you hike right to them.
Well, that's great.
If they haven't left, they're probably the type of guys who would help you get through that fence.
So I'm there. There's a gate. I need to go all the way. Where? Thunder Canyon. Do I need to go? I wonder where the June fire is. Ruby River is way over there. Nice. Alright, well, here we go, I guess. Map. Oh man, that's butts. Alright. This video might have to be cut short. We'll see. But I'm gonna go ahead and apologize in case it does. What was that? Alright. Pretty sure I need to go this way. I need to go south. East. So yeah, it should be a pretty straight line after I get over here. Right? That's the wrong way, isn't it? Son of a bitch. Where did I end up? I don't even know. There I am. Nope. I turned all the way around somehow. Somehow I ended up over here. What? I don't know how that worked. But there's a trail here somewhere. I don't know how that worked. That's what I'm talking about. You can get lost in this. Music too.
I'm wandering around east of the lake. Which way is Ruby River?
It's in the southeast corner of your map. The scout camp where the firefighters were staged should be on your map. It looks like a little triangle with a flat bottom.
Yeah, it looks like a tent.
How did I never see that before?
Yeah, it looks like a tent. That's funny.
Nope.
Let go of my mouse to scratch my arm. Ooh. The sensitivity on this is high. My DPI is pretty high. I gotta go around everything. Gotta try to find a way around everything. Right. Ooh, stuck. Can't go that way. No, I'm supposed to stay up. Go back home. Alright. Cut. I went the wrong way. Go back up and back to the Two Forks place.
Has anything strange been happening on your end?
No, nothing really.
Nothing really or nothing?
Nothing. My door was open the other night, but that's not strange.
That doesn't sound like nothing.
It's nothing, I promise.
All right, I'm headed toward the camp anyway.
Would that be nothing to you?
Okay. Keep your radio close to you.
Should I come home?
Hey, what you just said, keep my radio close to me.
Yeah?
Before I got attacked back at the lake, I saw a radio on the ground, kind of like the one I use.
And?
Do you think that maybe someone was, you know,
I don't know. What?
Maybe intercepting our frequency with other radios or something.
Henry.
It's just a thought.
I don't even know how you would do that.
Yeah, well, you sound worried.
No, I'm not. Okay, let's not spin out of control. Just keep hiking.
Whatever you say, boss.
Back here. Already been here. Alright, then I need to go.
I know we don't know what's going on yet, but I don't have a good feeling. I don't like feeling vulnerable. It's not like you could just call the police. I was thinking about the Goodwins.
Going on this way.
It just struck me that if anything weird like this happened to them, happened to Brian, just how scared he would have been.
He had his dad to protect him. Ned, right?
I found where they did the controlled burn. I can hike right through here now.
Yeah, normally they wouldn't do that so close to a body of water, but I think they're extra worried about a fire jumping the river and burning up to Two Forks now that there's someone in it.
Well, I'm extra appreciative of that.
Let's see. The scout camp is southeast of the river. There should be a pond on the way.
Got it. What happens if a controlled burn gets out of control?
Someone gets fired.
Ugh, are you serious?
Oh, come on. That one was an honest accident. I'm not even in the mood for wordplay. That's how wound up all this shit has me.
There's some old snowmobiles out here.
That's crazy.
Looks like one of the poor bastards was cruising across this pond and dumped it.
There's an old pond out here, not much more than a pile of mud. Do you have it on your map?
Yeah, I know where you are.
Yeah? Where am I?
Pork Pond. There used to be a sign up for it, but, well, folks kept stealing it.
Because it's called Pork Pond?
The bridge to the camp is out.
Damn.
I'm gonna walk the ravine and see if I can find some high ground to get across.
Good plan.
That's where I'm gonna have to go. Ooh. My blind pulls.
I'm at the camp.
Great. Have a look around. If anyone's still there, they might be able to help.
I guess these little shelters are where they keep the weeblows.
35 years, yeah.
See nothing in this. Go this way. Nice.
Yeah, these guys are gone. Found where they were sitting around before getting picked up. Hey, Dee, they left something behind. It's like a memo from their boss. Next few days, dropping into the thoroughfare on behalf of Dr. Simmons at Wapiti Station.
Wapiti Station?
Holy crap.
Keep reading.
Oh, I just thought I would maybe, you know, stop there, let the mystery percolate.
My mother always said I would meet someone who'd give me a taste of my own medicine.
They're running a research site out there. He was worried about wildfires.
Someone is writing down our conversations. And now we find out there's a research site out here that we don't know about? What are they researching?
Us. They're researching us.
You think they're studying you and me?
I do. Yeah.
That's a poop trail.
Maybe it's about
there's poop on
studying
there.
Two strangers who talk every day.
Like, if you put someone in isolation with someone else, what they do?
Yeah, that's what I think.
Fuck that.
Agreed.
That's what I'm
I think we should allow for the possibility that this is all just a big misunderstanding, but...
Yeah.
God, if you saw what you said you did... Fuck, Henry.
Yeah, I saw it.
Okay. So what's next?
Well, I've got an axe, so I can figure out a way to get over the ravine and back towards the site.
Sounds good. Check in when you can. Keep an eye out for anyone following you.
Alright, that's all I have time for right now. Let's make another episode. Leave a like, comment, subscribe, and share. And as always, I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.